This week, the film talk will bring to you.
So now what?
Yeah, thank you for having me. It is an honor to be in the film talk.
Hi everyone, I'm Muhammad Raiz bin Mahfaizal from British Film Institute, one of video critics.
I'm Muhammad Firdaus. I'm a video critic from British Film Institute.
Today, I want to critique about a movie called Bohemian Rhapsody, which is produced in 2018.
Can you tell us what is Bohemian Rhapsody is all about?
Bohemian Rhapsody is a biographical drama film of a popular lead singer of Queen, named Freddie Mercury.
The revolutionary songs and popular song of a Queen band led to its rise in the 1970s.
After Freddie Mercury left the band for going solo,
he reunites with the Queen band members to perform on Live Aid,
resulting one of the greatest performances in rock and roll history.
The star of this movie is Rami Malek, play the character as Freddie Mercury.
Mr. Firdaus, what will you critique?
I will critique on positive critical incidents. There are many positive things in the movie that we can see. I will critique and I will point out only three of them. First is professionalism, and then communication, and lastly, cultural competence. In this scene, the band are reunited on a meeting. Freddie wants to rebuild the band to prepare for the upcoming Live Aid concert. The scene is where Freddie apologizes to Queen and takes on conditions requested by the bandmates.
Shall we go to professionalism?
Yes.
Okay, good. Before I start to critique, we should watch a scene excerpt of the film that we want to discuss on.
Asta, I've been hideous. I know that, and I deserve your fury. I've been conceited, selfish.
Professionalism that I can found in the movie is ethical behavior, accountability. Okay, this is shown by Freddie. Okay, Freddie says, "I've been hideous. I know that I deserve your fury. I've been conceited, selfish." So Freddie admits his wrongdoing to his band members, and in the meeting, and apologizes to the band members. So for sure, that will resolve their internal problems and strengthening their bond. But a little bit recommendation, try to say sorry earlier so other people can be clear on your intention. For communication, positive thing that I can point out is assertive communication.
From now on, every song, no matter who wrote it, music, lyrics, it's by Queen. Not one of us, just Queen. All the money, all the credits, split four ways, evenly.
Okay, So when John say from now on, every song, no matter who wrote it, music, lyric, is by Queen, not one of them. This shows that he is an assertive communicator, because he's being clear and direct on what he wanted, and he also say it with calm and clear tone. That is our characteristics for assertive communicator. Okay, recommendation, not improvement that the Bohemian Rhapsody crew should improve, but recommendation for all of us watching the film talk. Okay, being clear on what we want is good to ensure effective communication. So make sure you are clear enough in communication. The next, the last one, is cultural competence.
All the money, all the credits, split four ways evenly.
Done.
The cultural competence is adaptability. This we can see from Freddie Mercury, in the meeting scene. Okay, when Freddie's respond done after listening to John's request, technically the whole member request, that indicates Freddie can fastly adapt to conditions that, you know, was not his nature, because he was a person that conceited, so proud of himself, so selfish, but he tried to adapt because he values his bandmates. Okay, and then Freddie's action can ease the process of solving conflicts, of course, because of his action, the resultants, the process of solving the conflicts can be eased. Recommendation, instead of saying done, try to be more polite and say I agreed. That is more formal and more polite.
Mr. Ray, full critic negative critical incidents, right? Tell us the synopsis of the selected excerpt, please.
And now, I want to talk about a synopsis of the scene excerpt of negative critical incidents. In this scene, the band and the manager, John Reed, are having a discussion with Ray Foster, executive of EMI Records. They discuss about releasing an album called A Night at the Opera. The band want to stick with their intention to release an album like opera but in a rock and roll genre, but not to Ray Foster, who want to stick with the current formula of making song to get a hits album, because Ray Foster believe that if they stick with the formula, they can get a hits album like a previous album such as Killer Queen that make them top of the US Billboard. And now I want to talk about a first point of negative critical incident, which is professionalism. An employee consider a thorough professional if he knows how to manage his time well. For example, coming early to the office every day, or coming on time to the office every day. This one a good example of a good professional. In this scene, what I want to focus on is time management.
You're late.
Am I? Saved your seat?
Lovely.
This is a scene where Freddie comes late to their band discussion with executive of EMI Record, which is Ray Foster, and also attended by their manager and their band lawyer. John Rick said, "You are late." Instead of telling the reason why he's late, Freddie replies with "Am I?" That's a little bit bad manners, or bad example for us. What I want to recommend here is Freddie need to know how to manage his time well And in other way, he should have informed the bandmates earlier if he accidentally late but with a reasonable excuse. So the next point of a negative critical incident is a passive communication. Passive communication is defined as a style in which individuals develop a pattern of avoiding expressing their opinions. Passive communicator is usually born in a low self-esteem, which is less confident.
Right, now that everybody's got an acceptable name, let's get to it. Look, we just really need something special. More hits. Like Killer Queen, only bigger.
It's not bloody widgets we're making. We can't just reproduce Killer Queen.
No. We can do better.
So in this scene, when Ray Foster said, we really need something special, more hits like Killer Queen, only bigger, and then the drummer, Roger Taylor, reply, it's not the bloody widgets we are making, we can't just reproduce the Killer Queen. That's mean the Roger Taylors means it's difficult for them to make an album like previous album Killer Queen, which made them top of the US Billboard. This also means the drummer is a passive communicator with low self-esteem. He is lack of confidence on what they try to do. He also say it with an annoyed or unsatisfied tone. In this scene, what I want to recommend is, instead of Roger say it's not the easy way to make the album, he need to ask first how he want the produce album. They want to produce album because jump into the conclusion can trigger feeling of anger in communication actually. Cultural competence is defined as an awareness, knowledge and skill that we needed to work with others. In this scene, what I want to focus is self-awareness.
Okay, so now that we're all here, Jim, this is Ray Foster. Ray, this is the band's lawyer, Jim Beach.
Oh, you must stop calling him that.
That's his name.
No, we cannot keep calling him Jim Beach. No, that's absurd, not to mention unspeakably boring.
This is where after Freddy arrived at the discussion room, he deliberately smoked a cigarette and interrupted John Reed's line that introduced Ray Foster and Jim Beach. You must stop calling him that, he said. This show that Freddy did not create self-awareness. In fact, he endangers the life of non-smokers while smoking in discussion room. What I want to recommend about this scene is Freddy should not smoke in the discussion room, but he can smoke in the smoking area after discussion.
Great. So any advice to conclude all of the points?
In conclusion, communication-wise, basic of communication is a real thing that we need to focus on because it is our daily basis.
We must be clear and concise on what we want when having communications.
Finally, it is essential for us to have good manners, to choose our words wisely when we want to talk, because whatever comes out from our mouth is our real self.
Thank you so much, guys. Really appreciate your points.
Yeah. It's my pleasure, to be in the film talk. And I'm very grateful that I can share what I think about the film Bohemian Rhapsody and what I can point out for us to be learned.
Thank you for having me today as your video critics of Bohemian Rhapsody movie.
Thank you.
See ya.